Hello friends, welcome back to next one. In this session we are going to develop very important utility which is file and environment. Using this we are going to consume data from the property file. So right click, create a new class, and we are going to give a name as a file and environment. So in this class we have to define a logic how we are getting the data from the property file and how we can use in server classes. So first thing will be I have to create a map object. So this will be my static object, public static map. So here I am going to use generics will be a string and string. So I am going to consume a data in a string format. File and environment is equal to new as map. Apart from this we need to call a property file, so we are using the property file. So public static properties, so this will be under property file, comes under the java.util. so here you can see here there are two different packages. So one is sun xml and one is java.util. so we are going to consume data from the java.util class. So this is the inbuilt package of Java. So using this we are going to consume the data, or we are going to read the data from the property file. Property main is equal to new properties, and again I am going to use one more probe. So don't worry about this, we will understand whenever we are going to use. So now to get the data we are going to consume data from the property file, and it will return the value as a map. So whatever data we have here, server URL, port number, username, so this data we are storing as a map object. So for that we need to create static method public static, and argument will be map. So map which comes under Java util. So generics will be again string and string. And this will be my environment and file. So class will be, method will be environment and file. So this will going to return me a map object of all the data whichever I have used in the property file. So it will be written a file and environment. So now thing is we need to write a logic here. So first thing, how we are getting the data? To get the data we are using system.set properties. So again we will understand, so what is system.get properties here? System.get properties. And we need to pass an environment value. So system, let's say we are passing here server or environment or anything string you can pass, and we are storing as a reference variable of string. So this will be my environment, and the type will be a string. So now what is the meaning of this line? So what this line will do? So whenever we are running the test on particular environment, so VM argument we have to pass this as a env, and we have to pass environment name. So this we will see how while we are running the test. So first let me put everything inside the try and catch block so we can get read out of the error. So try, if there will be server condition, so we are using three property files, so dev, QA and staging. So if environment, this is plain English, if environment is equal to, so my environment, whatever environment I am passing, let's say I am passing QA environment or I am passing a dev environment. So let's say first will be my dev environment. So whenever I am going to consume data as a dev, so let me use the case block so we can understand. Yeah. So first thing will be a dev environment. So in dev environment, what we are going to do? We are going to get data from the dev property file. So how we can do that? First, we need to write file input stream. File and input stream which comes under the java.io file input stream. So do not import wrong things or wrong packages. So this will be my fish dot. So this will be my local environment is equal to new file input stream. So here I have to define the file. So how we can define the file? So using the for this, first we need to get a project location. So how we can get system dot get property. So using that, this line, what this line will do? This line will get the path up to this package. So my path will be a, so I have to pass argument user.dir. So this line will give me a path up to my package, because currently I am going to use my my system, but whenever I am pushed in the Git or whenever other guy is going to use, so based on the system or their project directory, this location will be a change. So we cannot use a hard coded location. So this system dot get property will consume the or will directly give the location up to this my framework, and then I have to give only a my after then I have to give only this location. So it is automatically going to get this property file in whichever system I am going to use. So this will be my inputs slash dev dot property, dev dot properties. And now I have created a map object. So I am calling this property file, I am getting this property file, and I have to load the property file. So using this properties, what we can do? Property main dot load, we are going to consume this data. So what we are going to use this particular environment, so fish dev. So this is going to load a property file. Now after that, whatever property we have, we are going to put in a map object. So this will be my map. So inside this I am going to put dot put, and I have to give a string and value. So I have different values. So first thing will be a server URL. So first I am going to use server URL. So my key will be a server URL. Let me zoom it. Yeah. So first thing will be a server URL and value. So how I'll get the value? So I am going to give this environment variable. Sorry, variable for the property file, property main dot get property, and whatever value I have given there. So do not change any character here. We need to give exit values whatever we have defined here. So this will be my server URL. So I have to give here server URL. So this will add server URL in my map object. So similar way I'll do for the other stuff as well. So whatever other value we have used. So we have used port number. So I'm this key, you can give any key, but get property, this string will be exact whatever we have defined in the property file. So your username, and we are going to consume a password. So this will be my password. So this is set for the one environment. Now we have to define for the another environment. If now we have to use else if, and we have to give another condition. So another condition is my another environment will be a QA. So whenever I am going to use a QA environment, so instead of QA dev, I have to give QA, and the same information I have to pass there as well. So the same information I have to pass here, and property file name will change. So Earlier it was dev, now I have to give QA and rest of the information will be same. So this local variable also you can change. So instead of fish dev, you can give fish QA. So this is done for another environment. Now we have to edit for one more environment. So let me simply copy this. We need to just change some values. So which is staging, here will be a staging instead of QA, this will be a staging, and this will be again, I can write fish staging. So whatever argument we are passing from VM argument, based on that it is going to, my compiler is going to get from this class to property file, and using that it is going to get information of server URL, port number, username, password or whatever value. Let's say you have 10 values, you can define all the values here and you will get values as a map object and you can consume the value from the map object. So this is all set for the getting the value. Now this thing will return me a file and environment. So this line will return me a file and environment. Now the thing is, we need to create another object, another method, which is public static, another map object. So this will be a string and value I am going to consume as a string, and get config reader. So it is again going to, I have to return a map object, so which is file and environment. So let's say my file and environment is equal to null. So what I am going to do, I am assigning to this method to our method. So environment and file, which is this method. So it is going to consume this data and it will return a web object simply. Yeah, so we have created file and environment. In next session, we are going to implement the extent report. Thank you guys. Thanks for the watching the video.